How's it going, everybody? Triple-Dunc here on The Walking Dead. Okay, this is not the Walking Dead fan-made game or anything like that. This is Telltale Games, The Walking Dead. And if anybody doesn't know what Telltale Games is about, it's like, you know, episodes and story and choices and all that stuff. So this is my, well, this is my first time playing the PC version, but let's just see how it goes. New game. Play. Standard. As you can see, you know, episodes, fun episodes, stuff, so let's move on along here. Yeah, see, this game series adapts to the choices you make. The story is tailored by how you play. But grab some popcorn, grab something to drink, because these videos will be the entire episode length, and some are longer, some are shorter than the others, so just letting you know, be ready for longer videos. Episode 1, A New Day. Okay.
Well, I reckon you didn't do it then.
Didn't do what?
Why do you say that?
You know, I've driven a bunch of fellas down to this prison. Lord knows how many. Usually it's about now I get the, I didn't do it. But you don't talk too much, do you?
Oh, I can look around here. It's a nice sunny day in the world of The Walking Dead. That is a rare sight.
I followed your case a little bit, you being a Macon boy and all.
You're from Macon, then?
Yep. Came up to Atlanta to be a city cop in the 70s. Always wanted to work a murder case, like that senatorial mess you got yourself mixed up in. With all due respect. A real shame, that is. Hell, the whole family used to be regulars at your folks' drugstore right in downtown. Still there?
Sure is.
Good.
He advised medical personnel en route to Hartsfield, various 1020 coming in.
So,
I got a nephew up at UGA. You teach there long?
Going on my 6th year.
You meet your wife in Athens?
That's a little deep.
You want to know how I see it?
Sure.
Sure.
Regardless, could be you just married the wrong woman.
Oh, you just went there, buddy. You did not just say that to my face. And I can't even swear at you because I'm in the cop car.
Riot in progress. All officers are available for incoming 217. Rolling calls and dispatches to all locations.
Looks like someone's got zombie troubles. Okay. So, apparently this game takes place in Macon.
This man once. He was the worst one. He wouldn't stop going on about how he didn't do it. He was an older fella, big soft eyes behind a pair of smart folk glasses. And he just wailing back there. Says it wasn't him. Crying and snotting all over right where you're sitting.
Hey, you might need to listen to that.
Before long, he starts kicking the back of the seat like a fussy baby on an airplane. And I tell him he's got to stop. But that's government property, and I'll be forced to zap him otherwise. So he stops, and having exhausted all his options, he starts crying out for his mama. Mama, it's all a big mistake. It wasn't me.
Did he do it?
So did he do it?
They caught the fucker red-handed, stabbing his wife, cutting her up as the boys came through the door. He sits in my car screaming bloody murder that it wasn't him. I think he actually believed it himself. It goes to show, people up and go mad when they believe their life is over. I got another good one for you.
Hey, you need to pay attention to the road, man. Seriously.
What's up? This other time...
Jesus. Dungeon. Oh, crap. Ew, he's getting eaten alive. That sucks.
Oh, shit. Thirsty. Ah, fuck, my leg.
Okay, this will be, okay, where am I? What's up, officer?
Hey! Hey, officer! Are you alright? I'm still cuffed back here!
Why the hell did he have his gun out?
Because he was shooting some zombos, man! Just kicked the glass. Time to get out of here. And he's falling down all oh shit. That's a hard fall. Thank God it's only its leg though. After all that. He probably was wearing a seatbelt. Smart man. Where's the... Take the shotgun shell. Alright, just in case if I need it. Which I'm probably gonna need it pretty soon. Because he's probably gonna die. First, I need to grab these. Really? God, you are a clumsy man! I'm gonna get you! I'm gonna get you! Come on, you gotta have some humor in this. Yep, he's the undead now.
Officer?
Holy shit!
Yep, he's undead. Got back off.
Get away from me!
Grab the gun. Are you kidding me? All the worst luck ever.
Don't make me do this!
Well, you're gonna have to. You gotta do what you gotta do to survive. Especially in the zombie world. I mean, no joke. I'm just drinking some coffee. Don't mind me. Hey, can you help me out here?
Go get someone! There's been a shooting!
What am I looking at? Oh, Schneike. You gotta move now. I'm sorry if I'm laughing. It's just he's so clumsy. God. See? I mean, I know his... Oh, God, he's gonna... Come on. Thank God zombies don't know how to climb. Thank God on that one.
Hello? Anybody?
Alright, I'm gonna take this second to, continue. Okay, so we're in Georgia. That is where Macon is, if you guys didn't know. Macon's in Georgia.
I'd fill one of those teacups with some bourbon if I could.
That's a good idea.
No ladder. I'm not getting up there anyway. This leg the way it is.
Help!
That's a good hideout for the little girl for zombies. Not, you know, because zombies can't climb, as we can already see that.
Anybody up there?
Alright. Let's check inside the house. There's nothing much out here. God, I don't even know this guy's name.
I wonder if anybody's home.
Hello? Anybody home? I need a little help. Coming in. Don't shoot, okay?
Now, it's not really breaking and entering. I mean, I did, you know, knock and ask first. Especially in the zombie world where there is no law.
Not an intruder. Or one of them.
The only law is survival of the fittest. And don't get eaten. Pool of blood? How far could you be from?
Jesus.
Nice. I like that. Alright, I'm gonna check for some supplies. And again! You're clumsy! Jesus. And now you're all bloodied up and... Yeah. Huh. Don't mind if I do.
What's that beeping?
Nothing.
This place has been ransacked. Just about anything worthwhile is gone.
You don't know that. I mean, you can assume that.
Three new messages.
I'll check those messages later. Ooh, hey, a radio. See? There's one useful thing out of all this. Well, walkie-talkie, not an actual radio, but... It's kind of a difference. Yeah, might as well be thorough.
furniture overturned, blood everywhere. Jesus.
Someone didn't have a fun time. Don't even watch the television.
Cable's out. This whole neighborhood is deserted.
There are three new messages.
What the hell?
I'm getting there, stupid answering machine.
God, that kid lived here.
You didn't notice that from the coloring book?
Three new messages. Message one, left at 5:43 p.m.
Hey, Sandra, this is Diana. We're still in Savannah. Ed had a little incident with some crazy guy near the hotel, so we had to get him back to the ER and have it checked out. Anyway, he's not feeling well enough to drive back tonight, so we're staying an extra day. Thanks so much for looking after Clementine, and I promise we'll be back in time before the spring break.
Message 2, left at 11:19 p.m.
Oh my God, finally. I don't know if you tried to reach us. All the calls are getting dropped. They're not letting us leave and aren't telling us anything about Atlanta. Please, please, just leave the city and take Clementine with you back to Murrieta. I've got to get back to the hospital. Please let me know that you're safe.
Message 3, left at 6:51 a.m.
Clementine, baby. If you can hear this, call the police. That's 911. We love you. We love you. We love you.
Damn. So, what I'm assuming...
Daddy?
Huh? Hello?
You need to be quiet.
Are you okay?
Are you okay?
I'm okay. They tried to get me, but I'm hiding until my parents come home.
Where are your parents?
Where are your parents?
They took a trip and left me with Sandra. They're in Savannah, I think, where the boats are.
Are you safe?
Are you safe?
I'm outside in my treehouse. They can't get in.
See, I knew it! Smart. I knew it was a good idea.
See? Can you see me? I can see you through the window.
What's up? And the babysitter's a zombie. That's freaking great. No, not really. You're closing! God! I'm gonna kick you in the face! Jesus! Kick! Or... Oh! Hey! Hey, I need that hammer! Come on! Really? Come on! Let go! Kick in the face! Grab it! And you have to go. That's a bit overkill, but, you know, that's still a success, I guess. Sucks you have to be all Man. Bloodied up, though.
Hi there.
Did you kill it?
Yeah.
Yes.
It's okay. I think she was a monster.
I think so, too. You've been all by yourself through this?
Yeah. I want my parents to come home now.
I think that might be a little while, you know?
Oh.
Look, I don't know what happened, but I'll look after you until then.
What should we do now?
We We need to find help before it gets dark.
Yeah, it's not safe at night.
Let's go. Stay close to me.
Okay, so, like, I'm trying not to interrupt the cutscenes or anything. Okay, so, where I'm getting at right now is that me, as the character, finds this girl stuck in a treehouse, and her parents are in a vacation? In the middle of a zombie apocalypse? Why would you leave your daughter alone with a babysitter that end up as a zombo? I mean, still, though. I don't know. That's just probably bad parenting, but that's just me. Oh yeah, and speaking of The Walking Dead, I wonder where this aligns with the show, or the original comics, or whatever.
Man, I ain't never getting home to Mama at this rate.
This sucks. Oh, it's hot dish night.
Aww, someone's missing their meal.
What's the matter?
Should I stay?
What?
I don't want to sleep in the treehouse tonight, but I don't know if I should leave. What if my parents come home?
I won't leave you alone.
Let's go somewhere safe that's close, okay?
That's a good idea.
Hey, man!
Holy shit!
Don't eat us!
We're not gonna hurt you.
Yeah. Thought for a second you and the little one were both gonna give us the chomp.
We're just looking for help, man.
We need help.
Are you trying to get out of here? Because you should be. Those things are all over the damn place. I haven't seen anything as gnarly as this neighborhood since downtown Atlanta, 15 miles back. I'm Sean. Sean Green.
Lee. This is Clementine.
Okay, now I know my character's name. Lee?
I'm Chet.
We shouldn't be out in the open like this. How about you help us clear the way, and we'll take you and your daughter out of here and down to my family's farm. It should be safer there.
I'm not a dad.
I'm just some guy. No, I'm her babysitter.
Her babysitter. Her parents are out of town.
That's not technically all a lie.
Let's get going.
I am watching over her, and her parents are in vacation. So.
What do you want to do?
Yeah.
I...
It's just that her original babysitter got chomped up.
The monster's coming.
We gotta go.
Lee, quick.
Hammered.
Let's go.
Okay, come on.
As babysitters go, I'd say her parents owe you a tip.
Yep. A big one.
Sean, I'm gonna run on home. My mama's gonna be in a snit.
No sweat, man. I'll catch you tomorrow night.
It was nice to meet you both.
Thank God you're okay.
I was worried it'd be bad here, too.
Been quiet as usual the past couple days. Old Brecken down the way thinks his mare's gone lame, but that ain't nothing new.
I wouldn't have made it back without Chet.
Well, I'm glad you took him with you then. You've brought a couple guests.
Your boy's a lifesaver.
Your boy's a lifesaver. Glad he could be a help to somebody. So it's just you and your daughter, then?
Oh, not his daughter. He's the babysitter.
Honey, do you know this man?
Yes.
Okay, then. Well, looks like you hurt your leg pretty bad there.
Yeah, it's not doing so good.
I can help you out. Sean, run on in and check on your sister. You, take a seat up on the porch and I'll go see what I have.
Okay, you're asking a lot of questions. But I guess it's okay. We're total strangers to you, after all.
Let's have a look. Yeah, this is swollen to hell.
It could be worse.
Could be worse.
That's what it sounds like. Seems like things got awful bad in the cities. What did you say your name was?
It's Lee.
It's Lee.
Nice to meet you, Lee. I'm Herschel Green.
Hey, Herschel! Yeah! From the show!
How'd this happen?
Car accident?
Car accident.
That's so. Where are you headed before the car accident?
Home.
Where's home?
I grew up in Macon. We hit a guy. One of those things you've been hearing about. On the road.
Who are you with? The girl?
Hey! Hey! Stop asking me a lot of questions!
Nobody. Is that so?
Yeah. It is.
You said we. That's all. House is full up with mine. We got another displaced family of three sleeping in the barn. You and your daughter are welcome to rest there when we're done here. I didn't catch your name, darling.
Clementine.
Can't imagine what you've been through, Clementine.
I'm looking after her until we find her parents.
Hey, Dad. So I'm thinking, first thing tomorrow, we gotta reinforce the fence around the farm.
That doesn't seem necessary.
I don't know what you saw on TV or heard on the radio, but there's some serious shit hitting the fan. I don't think anyone knows how big it is yet.
Your son is right on that one.
You're going to want to fortify this place.
Stuff like that doesn't happen around here, Sean.
Dad, I'm serious. Lee, come on. Tell him what you saw out there, man.
I got chased by a couple of dead people.
Now I sound like a loony.
Well, do what you think you should. We got plenty of chores as it is.
Lee and those folks in the barn can help out in the morning. We gotta do it. Really.
I already said okay. Well, I'm all done here. It should start to feel better tomorrow.
Thanks.
If your leg gets hot or the swelling doesn't go down, you're probably dealing with an infection.
What do we do then?
We'll probably just have to shoot you. We'll clean it, redress it, and you'll be fine.
Okay, that'd be preferable.
There's blankets and such in the barn. We'll be seeing you bright and early. Come tomorrow, which way you think you're headed?
Towards Macon, I suppose.
Okay, so...
All right, then.
Herschel in this game is not as nice as he is in the show. And yeah, I did see the show and...
It
smells
like...
Manure.
Manure.
Manure? Like when a horse plops?
Just like that.
Yup.
My mom and dad.
I bet, Clem.
How far is Savannah?
Pretty far.
Oh, okay.
But anyway, like I was saying, I have seen the show, and it's actually pretty good. I mean, to my opinion, but... Huh.
Hey, get up.
I'm itchy.
Well, you slept in a barn, little lady. Lucky you don't have spiders in your hair. But I bet your daddy scared them all away, huh?
I'm not her dad. Name's Lee.
I'm Kenny.
Dad, we're in the middle of the fence. There's a tractor and everything.
We better get going, or we won't hear the end of it. That's my boy, Ken Jr. We call him Duck, though.
Duck?
Doc?
Yeah, nothing bothers him. Like water off a duck's back, you know?
That's a valuable treat lately.
No kidding. But frankly, I think it's because he's dumb as a bag of hammers. But he makes up for it with enthusiasm.
Alright.
The word is, you were on your way to Macon.
My family's from there.
Well, Macon's on the way, and personally, I'd appreciate the company of a guy who can knock a couple of heads together if he has to.
I'll ask the girl.
I'll see what the girl would like.
Ah, gotta consult the missus. I understand. Honey, Duck, this is Lee. And, what's the girl's name?
Clementine.
Clementine.
That is a very pretty name.
Thanks.
Well, we should get to work. We've all seen what those things can do out there, so the faster we get this fence up, the better.
I want to build a fence.
Yeah? Well, I need a good foreman. You can sit on the tractor and yell at me whenever I take a water break.
On the tractor? Cool!
Duck and I will hop to it.
I can keep an eye on your little girl here on the porch. We can visit.
See, I just met this guy, and he's already pretty cool. Not like Herschel, which asked me a whole bunch of freaking questions. Where are you from? What's up with
you? You're having a nice time with Katya Clementine.
Yeah.
I'll talk to Kenny first.
Hey there, Kenny. Need any help?
No, I think I got it. Do you need any help?
What do you mean?
Well, I mean in taking care of that little girl. You know what you're doing? You got kids of your own?
I have no idea.
I have no idea what I'm doing.
At least you're honest. Shit. Better than I was when Duck showed up. You'll figure it out.
What's your plan?
So what's your family's plan?
Get back on down to Lauderdale and let this mess get sorted out. Government will start handing out shots and the National Guard will do its thing. On the odd chance things got too bad, we could hop on my boat, I guess.
You've got a boat?
I'm a commercial fisherman, catching mackerel, dolphin, whatever's biting and paying. Katya wouldn't be wild about it, but the boat's not that bad.
See ya.
Okay, so Kenny's got a boat, which is actually quite handy.
Hey there, girls. You two actually look relaxed.
I think we're doing just fine. Clementine was just telling me about first grade.
Oh, how's that?
It's easy.
Well, yeah. So, you're good?
Anyway, it's almost like we didn't see people eating each other for the past 3 days. It's peaceful here, no?
So, what are you doing? Corpses aren't walking around.
I'm a veterinarian back in Fort Lauderdale. Like Herschel here, except more with dogs and cats and not horses. What is it that you do, Lee?
I used to teach up at the University of Georgia.
We need to hope that we can go back to our jobs soon, Lee. Back to normal. It can't stay like this.
Oh.
We'll all be home soon.
My bad. I was distracted for a second. Alright.
Back in a bit.
Okay, Lee.
Time to go see what Duck and Sean is up to? I think his name is Sean. What's up, Duck? He looks like he's having so much fun on that tractor.
How you doing, Duck?
Good. I'm going to drive the tractor. I'm the foreman. Lift with your back, Sean.
That's funny.
Hey, Lee.
Need a hand?
That'd be great. If you could cut those two-bys to length, that'd sure speed things up. My dad doesn't know how bad it is.
No, he doesn't.
I saw a guy in Atlanta kill a kid. A boy. Just shot him right in the face.
Damn?
Damn. Oh shit, damn. He didn't even hesitate. He just turned, put the barrel of the gun right between the kid's eyes, and pulled the trigger.
Well, you gotta...
You don't see things like that. It's not like in the movies.
They don't fall like you think.
You gotta do what you gotta do, though, to survive.
Do what?
You know?
Kill. Have you had to off one yet?
Oh,
sometimes it's kill or be killed?
It's kill or be killed.
I guess. I don't think I'd sleep good after that. I'm just glad we're getting this fence built. Dad just wants to keep the family safe and thinks inviting people in is a bigger threat than whatever's out there. How about yours? How's your family?
My parents.
My brother and parents are in Macon, I hope.
Oh man, I hope so too. Maybe it's not too bad there. That's probably all I need cut for now. Thanks.
And Sean, thanks again for the ride.
No problem, Lee. Couldn't leave you behind. Anyway, when you see my dad around, he might want some help in the barn.
Oh, your 20 billion question dad? Oh, where are you from? Oh, where are you guys heading off to? Blah, 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 blah. Seriously. I know you got trust issues, but...
You should know that if you weren't leaving with Kenny today, I wouldn't stand for your lack of honesty last night.
I'm not sure I follow.
I ain't dumb. I caught you in that lie last night about who you were with in that car. And honestly, I don't even want to know. How'd you get out of Atlanta?
Got a ride.
I got a ride and then I was in a wreck. I walked until your boy found me.
Well, you're no worse for wear.
This farm's a nice plot of land.
Huh. Had you told me 20 years ago I'd still be doing this, I would have told you that you were full of crap. Never was a plan, having a place like this. It was in the family, and I guess so was I. Family's important. It's all that matters. You agree with that?
Was brought up to, yes.
Where's your family now? Parents? Wife? Girlfriend?
God, you're still asking a bunch of questions.
My parents are in Macon with my brother.
Well, I hope they're all right. But now you've got this little girl to take care of. Clementine, is it? You just stumbled up on her?
What are you getting at?
What are you getting at?
Can I give you a piece of advice?
Sure.
I don't know who you are or what you did. Let's say things don't get better back in the cities, or they get worse before they do. You're gonna have to depend on the honesty of strangers if you're gonna make it. And if those same people get to questioning yours, you're gonna be in trouble. But at least you have the common sense to listen to a man giving you advice.
What the?
Okay.
Go! I'll get my gun!
That doesn't sound fun. Man, Duck! Oh, now I gotta make a choice. You serious?
My leg
is stuck. I gotta go. Duck!
Help me!
Come on! Come on! Back off, you zombie!
I got you! Now, Sean!
Get this tractor off of me! Please, help me, please!
It's too late. And she had to see that. Great. Well, now he's pissed.
Get out.
Get the fuck out of here!
I'm sorry.
Sorry?
Your son is alive.
You don't get to be sorry.
Hey!
And you! You didn't even try to help.
I was worried about the boy, man.
I was worried about the boy.
Look at him.
But you weren't worried about that.
Please. Just go.
Get out and never come back.
Sheesh.
You've got that ride to Macon if you want it.
Oh, thanks anyway.
Well, this is as far as we're going.
And it's far enough.
We're in Macon, I think.
Look!
Hey there, you friendly? Truck's run out of gas.
I don't think he's friendly.
Fuck!
Yeah, he's not friendly at all. Oh hey, you brought friends! What's up with that? I don't think he got bit. I mean, I think just a zombie just fell on him? I think? I don't know. It looks like it, but...
We can't take risks like this. And we can't just let people die, either. When I say that door stays shut no matter what, I fucking mean it. We don't know who these people are. They could be dangerous.
Hey, we're just trying to survive.
Where the hell is your humanity?
We're not dangerous. Just regular folks.
What's dangerous is a bunch of people running outside and drawing their attention to us.
Lee's right. We're just regular folks, but we actually like helping people.
You'll have to excuse her. The hell he or anyone will. This is about survival. Do you guys not see what's happening?
What is it?
I have to pee.
I'd go out there again in a second.
In a minute.
You would.
In a minute, Clem.
They've got kids, Lily.
Those things outside don't care.
Maybe you should go join them then. You'll have something in common.
God damn it, Lily. You have to control these people.
Carly and Glenn just ran out there.
I don't give a flying fuck. We're in a war zone.
She's not wrong. They took a risk.
Yes, we did.
And we appreciate it. Now let's settle down.
Holy shit. Son of a bitch. One of them is bitten.
Hey!
He wasn't bitten.
Hell, he wasn't. We have to end this now.
Hey!
Over
you're
my
not doing.
Dead body, we'll dig one hole.
No, I'm cleaning him up. There's no bite. He's fine.
Don't you fucking people get it? We've already seen this happen. We let someone with a bite stay in, and we all end up bitten.
Shut up. We gotta throw him out, or smash his head in.
Penny!
Whoa!
We, What do we do about this guy?
Dad, it's just a boy. It's...
Lily, I'll handle
it. But your heart, Dad. You need to calm down.
We kick his ass.
That's what I'm thinking.
Everyone, chill the fuck out! Nobody is doing anything.
Shut up, Lily. And you, shut the fuck up. They will find us, and they will get in here, and none of this will fucking matter. But right now, we're about to be trapped in here with one of those things.
What the hell are you talking about?
He's bitten! That's how you turn!
He's not bitten. Lee, stop this. It's upsetting him.
Oh, I'm upsetting him. Upsetting is getting eaten alive.
What if this was your daughter?
Never would have happened.
Sure it wouldn't.
She's a toddler, okay? She's United States Air Force.
Fuck you and her. I'm gonna kill him, Cat. Just worry about Duck.
You know, we all just met each other. Yeah.
There's someone in there.
It's just locked. Key's behind the counter. Probably.
Hey, I'm not the bad guy here. I'm just looking out for my daughter.
No, you're just the guy arguing for killing a kid.
He's covered in muck. She'll find the bite. Watch.
She won't.
And if she does, the first thing he'll do is sink his teeth into his mom's face. Then, when she's dead, he'll probably pounce on your little girl.
It's a little boy. I think we can handle him.
A little boy? He'll be an uncontrollable man-eater.
You know, I get where he's getting at, but he doesn't need to be doing it the way he is.
No! You don't touch that boy! You don't touch anybody! I've got a little girl I'm trying to protect in here, too. You wanna get violent, you old fuck? Well, come on! You better have a plan to kill me, though, because it's me before anyone else in here!
Zombie had to use the bathroom! That's one smart zombie! And clumsily again.
Get away from her, you son of a bitch! Oh, God. Get off!
Jesus.
Man.
She is one good shot.
You okay?
Just great, thanks.
Guys? Everybody down! Stay quiet!
They're gonna get in! Shut up!
Is that the military?
I don't know.
Thank God for whatever it is.
We almost died because of this bitch and the Richie trigger finger. That was stupid. That was...
Dad!
Oh, he has a heart condition. I forgot about that. Tell him to calm down.
I did try to get him to calm down.
Can it, asshole? It's his heart.
My pills.
Nitroglycerin pills? Yes, we're out. We've been trying to get into the pharmacy since we got here. Please try to get in there. Behind the counter where the pills are.
We'll do it somehow?
We'll get in there somehow.
Thank you so much. We need nitroglycerin pills. Please get in there. I'll keep an eye on my dad.
Everyone else should get comfy and look for anything useful. We could be in here a while.
I'm starting to think this drugstore isn't a permanent solution.
You're right. This ain't exactly Fort Knox.
What do you suggest?
We need as much gas as possible so we can all get out of downtown Macon. Fast.
Agreed.
Then I'll head out and get gas. There's a motel not too far from here, out towards the end of Peachtree. I'll work my way towards it and then loop back, siphoning what I can.
Why does he remind me of Glenn?
You know your way around? Local?
Born and raised.
If you're gonna do that, here's a walkie-talkie if you get in a tight spot. Hopefully, you won't need it.
Cool.
Clementine's got the other one. Check in with her and get back here as soon as you can.
And you, what's your name?
It's Lily. My dad's Larry.
Keep a good eye on him. These boys will work on getting you your medicine.
That's right.
And you keep an eye on that front door. You're our lookout. It's Doug. You got it.
And I'm Carly.
Okay, Carly. You'll shift in with Doug when he needs it. For now, get some rest.
You're a good shot, and I'd like to keep it that way.
You got it, boss.
Now get him those pills.
Alright, so that guy reminds me of Glenn. If you guys don't know from the show, he's actually quite helpful. Oh, hey, energy bar. Alright, let's just check around here. See what we can find around here. Might have to ration our food, but, you know, something's better than nothing.
Central High Tech State. Papers a week old. Feels like years. Looks like nobody got a chance to donate anything before this all went down.
Oh, this is his family's drugstore. So that's why he knows it so well. So we are in Macon. That's pretty sweet. Alright. Okay.
We can't let anything happen to Ducky.
I know, hon.
Maybe some more stuff around here. Oh, there's another bar. Hey, anybody want some ice cream?
We just need to get back to Fort Lauderdale.
We'll do our damnedest.
Yeah, I can't really see anything else, so I'm just gonna talk to her.
You're a pretty good shot.
Well, you don't fuck with a reporter, especially one that's 3 days out from her last cup of coffee.
What are you messing around with there?
A radio. I can't get it to work, though.
Here, let me have a look.
It's probably out of batteries.
There are no batteries in this thing.
What now?
You know that there are no batteries in that thing.
Yeah, of course. I mean, yeah. No.
I'll try to find some. Needs two.
Thanks. I wouldn't even really know what to look for.
You'd look for batteries. It's not that hard. See, I just found one. Now I gotta find the other one.
Try to get some rest, hon.
How can I with those things out there?
You guys find a battery around here? Just trying to find a radio battery. Okay. Carly. Doug. Okay, I'm going to move on along here.
Hey, Lee. You really gave that old man hell.
Yeah. We got pushed, you know?
You don't have to tell me. I was ready to tear the man's head off. Anyway, we, Kat and I, appreciate your support.
Thank you, Lee.
How's Duck doing?
He's okay. It was just a shock.
We're lucky as hell nobody got nabbed on the way in here.
No kidding.
How's she doing?
Well, her family's dead, so...
That's awful, Lee.
Yeah, well... She seems to be handling herself all right.
She's just a little girl, Ken.
Lee says she spent days on her own. That takes toughness.
It does.
But you have no idea what sort of emotional damage is happening to her every second her family is gone.
That's a little dark.
Lee, you got a second?
Sure.
back on Herschel's farm.
Yeah.
We didn't even try to save him. That blood is on our hands, you know?
Hey, it happened all pretty fast. We can't blame ourselves for that.
I guess. But I can't stop seeing him in my head.
We can't kill ourselves.
We killed that boy. We could have saved him together.
We did what we could. Bad things happened. We didn't make a choice that killed John. You think you do when you look back on it. But in a moment, when things are really out of control, you don't have any choice.
I guess.
Just get over it.
Try to let it go.
Alright, I'll give one of the pieces to Duck. He's probably starving.
It's not much, but here, for the boy.
Aw, thanks, Lee. He appreciates it.
That's sweet, Lee.
Give one to Clementine.
It's not much, but here you go.
Thank you.
Of course. Hey there.
Hi.
Can I get you anything?
I'm okay. Maybe I'm a little hungry.
Still, huh?
Yeah, it wasn't much.
I know, Clem. I'll see if I can find something else for you. Any word from Glenn?
Nothing. Is he okay?
Yeah, I think so. You're doing a good job. Well, sit tight.
Okay.
Okay, I'm trying to find that other battery. It's gonna bug me now.
Well, this battery should fit the radio.
Great. Thanks.
At least I found one. Okay. The angle of this stuff is ridiculous. Can't find anything in here. Alright. I'm not gonna worry about the battery right now. Just move on along. I think she's got it right. Ugh. Oh, that's not good.
I can't think about them in here.
This is his family's drugstore for, like, surety.
Find anything?
Hey! Where'd you come from? Just a picture.
Just a picture of whoever was here.
I know who you are.
Huh?
You're Lee Everett. You're a professor at Athens who killed a state senator who was sleeping with your wife. This is your parents' store. Folks around town know the owner's son got himself a life sentence, but I'm a reporter for WABE in Atlanta. I paid attention to that trial. Maybe you're a murderer, but I don't really care. Frankly, that's a skill that might come in handy. Did you tell anyone out there who you were, or that you were tied to this place?
No.
No. I've been sticking to first names for a reason.
You seem like an okay guy, and the last thing we need is drama out there. You've got this little girl to take care of, and look, don't make me wrong on this.
I don't plan to.
Good, because if this lasts longer than a few days, and you're a detriment to the group, then we'd have a problem.
I hear you.
I'll just keep it to myself.
Thank you.
Thanks.
Oh, I made her blush.
Don't worry about it.
Alright, let's move on along here.
What's that?
This was my dad's cane. He'd zip around here on it from time to time.
Was he sick?
Nah, he was okay. I actually saw him whoop shoplifters with it. This cane's protected this place better than any guard dog ever could. Plus, he knew how to make it look cool. Like you with your hat.
My dad gave it to me.
See, dads are smart like that. Better get this door clear, huh?
Can I help?
Sure.
Sure.
Why not?
Here we go. Watch your fingers in the drawers. Things have been scary, huh?
Yeah. It's not good. I don't know why everyone is crazy.
Neither do I, Clementine. Nobody does, I don't think.
I bet my dad does.
Okay, here we go.
Work those muscles.
Do you have kids?
No.
You don't have a family?
Do you play sports?
Let's not talk about that. Do you play sports?
I play soccer, but I don't really like it.
I'm not crazy about it either. All right, a little further.
Why don't you want to talk about your family? Do they, like, hate you?
I don't really know what happened with his family. I don't know.
Because they're dead.
Oh, I'm sorry.
You didn't know.
I'm just sorry for being mean.
Look, my family's gone and I just wish things would have been different.
Yeah.
I got into some trouble, and I didn't talk to him for a while. This used to be their store. But let's just keep that between you and me, okay?
Okay. Because of the trouble?
Yeah, that's right. Now, let's get this done.
Ow!
And she cut herself.
Are you okay?
I hurt my finger.
Is it bleeding?
A little.
Gotta find a band-aid.
I'll find you a bandage.
Alright. Oh, look, first aid kit. That should help. Okay.
Let's have a look at that finger. Ow.
It hurt.
Let's see if we can do something about it. Let's get this cut covered up.
Yes, please.
There you go. All better now.
Lee?
Yeah?
What if my parents come home and I'm not there?
They'll find us.
They'll, track us down. Don't worry.
Yeah, okay. We should keep a lookout. I've got my walkie-talkie in case they try that way.
Stay close to me until then, okay?
Okay. Radio. Or remote control.
It's locked. We need to track down the keys if we're gonna help Larry.
Let's go back. There's not much we can do here.
Wanna head back into the drugstore with me?
Okay. Lee?
Yeah?
You're not bad, right?
Why are you asking me that?
That lady said you killed someone. Was that because he was one of the things trying to eat you?
No.
No, he wasn't.
Oh. Was he bad?
He was.
What's up, Doug?
Heard or seen anything?
Nothing, luckily. Wanna step outside, have a look around?
I'm not suicidal yet.
No, the gate out there is closed. We can hang out in front of the store and be fine.
Oh, huh. Sure, let's go have a look around.
Cool. And we'll keep it down. Don't need to bring him back this way with any unnecessary noises.
Agreed. Jesus.
That's a lot of zombies. Just saying. Oh, look, they're having dinner.
I think I'm gonna be sick.
They just...
eat. As far as I can tell, that's all they care about.
And if one gets you...
they eat you. And whatever's left comes back as one of them.
How the fuck?
I think it might be more than a couple days before all this gets sorted out.
Yeah, I think so too. We better keep it down out of here.
Okay, nothing can do with that.
Man, that's a hasty fortification job over there.
Yeah, it didn't work.
Look at the one trapped over there.
Better him than us, huh?
That's his brother. Okay, then.
Oh, shit.
What? Do you know that guy?
It's... just sad.
No, it's just sad. Fucked up.
Yeah, it is.
God damn.
Look at the uniform, though. He could have worked at the drugstore and died with keys in his pocket.
It would take a lot of effort to make it safe enough to go out there and see if he has the keys. If we could somehow prove that he worked here, I think it'd be worth it.
I'll see what I can find. That guy over there has the keys.
How can you be sure?
I found this in the office. That boy in the photo worked here. The keys being on him is as good a bet as we can make.
Yeah, I agree. Just need to figure out how to get out there and get them. You wouldn't need long, right?
Nah, just a few seconds.
Maybe there's a way to distract them and buy you some time.
Okay. Well, we need to get... ooh, TVs.
Too bad we don't have a way to come out here and watch the news.
Would be nice to know what's going on elsewhere.
Atlanta's in rough shape, and that's all I know. Can't reach that brick. Doc, you want to get this door open?
About that.
You've got the combo, right?
No.
Really?
Did anyone ever have it?
Look, man, there were a lot of those things trying to get in here.
And now we can't get back out onto the street.
We're also party to some egregious fire code violations.
Alright, let's just get out.
Let's head back inside.
Okay.
Alright. Maybe if... grab that remote real quick. Because I think if somehow you knew how to get that controller, the remote, to link in with the other TVs, that might be a distraction?
It's the remote to my dad's TV.
I mean, you can do a lot of stuff with a lot of things. Alright. Alright, let's try to...
Hey, darling. You seem to handle yourself pretty well.
Really? I'm a disaster.
I can't tell.
My news editor was eaten about 5 feet away from me, and I would have joined her if it wasn't for that dorky guy on watch over there.
I'm sorry.
She was an asshole, but, you know.
Yeah. You ready to head out?
You got it. You?
I'm good.
Yeah.
Let's go.
Alright. Heading out to the hotel. Woohoo! Chevalier Hotel.
Shit. Get down.
Oh. Hi. How are you doing? I'm just passing through like a normal zombie. I'm just strolling. Oh god, there's a lot of them. Well, no, there's only 5 of them.
Did you see that?
I sure did. Be ready to shoot.
Guys! Oh man, I'm glad you're here.
Jesus, Glenn!
Oh, that is Glenn! That's sweet!
Right then wasn't so hard.
Can we get out of here before these things notice us?
Is this before the first season? Trapped up there. Of
no
the
way.
Actual
gotta
show?
Go now.
Listen, I was out here looking for gas, and then, up there in the corner room, I heard crying coming from inside.
Who is it?
It's a girl. We talked and she got frightened. I was trying to get in and help her, and she started yelling and saying I was bitten. I tried to convince her I wasn't, and that's when all these guys came out of the forest. A couple almost got me. And I ended up hiding in the ice machine.
Lucky you. Now let's go.
We can't just leave her.
Damn right we can't.
Really?
You guys are suicidal. Over a girl.
I'm saving her. With or without you.
Think about if it was you.
Fine. Let's go save Glenn's damsel in distress.
Okay.
Okay, this is the plan. We don't know how hard it's gonna be to get her out of that room.
Yeah, it's boarded up.
So we have to kill every one of them in here. Quietly. Noise attracts these things. Now let's have a look around.
Gotta go. Hi.
I wonder if there's anything in the pickup.
Yeah. I'm not gonna break that. Just for a freaking screwdriver.
There's a pillow over there.
That's about as far as I got when it came to supply gathering.
I might have an idea for it.
Good luck smothering them to death.
That's not really what I have in mind.
Smothering zombies from day one.
We can hide by that pickup. get out your gun.
But the noise.
Just follow my lead. Stay right behind me.
I'm gonna smother you. Hey.
That was sick.
Okay, one down, four to go. This could be handy.
It's a sparky thing.
Spark plug. You should hold on to that. Could come in handy.
Yep. Okay, let's go back over there. Got an idea. We use the spark plug.
Wait. Let me see the spark plug. The porcelain inside these things turns car windows to tissue paper.
Now we can grab this.
That could scramble a brain pretty good.
That's exactly what I was thinking.
Okay, now we gotta get over this way. Okay. You didn't see nothing. Na 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 na. You didn't hear anything. Yeah, I'm gonna bash your brains in. Three, two, what? No! Woo-hoo! Oh, God.
Get him! Nice.
Thanks for having my back.
For sure.
All right. Three down. Three to go. Wait. Okay. Push the car. There's an axe over there! That'll come in handy.
That was awesome!
Okay, I'm gonna scramble your brains up before I do this.
Dude, where'd your weapon go?
Into that ice pick sized hole.
Holy shit. It's cool. Now we've got this.
Are you two done?
Hey!
To war!
That should help.
Why don't you guys lag behind just in case this goes to hell?
Okay. We'll be right behind you.
This is a longer episode than I thought it would be. Tiptoe, tippy tippy toe, tippy 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 toe. Hopefully no zombo sees me. And I gotta kill you. What's up? How's it going? Oh!
Rat.
That's pretty cool.
Hello in there. We're here to help.
Please just go away.
Let's go, guys.
In a minute. If you open up, we can take you somewhere safer. We've got a group in town.
No.
Please. She's in trouble.
No. Miss, we're coming in.
She's probably bitten.
Stop! Just stop! I'm coming out.
Crazy lady.
You're hurt.
Oh, and you're probably bitten.
Stay away.
We need to get you help.
It's too late for that.
Guys, she's been bitten.
Oh, what did I tell you?
I said go away! I'm bit! But you wouldn't just leave.
Let's calm down. You could be fine.
I won't be fine. My boyfriend was bitten. You get sick and you die and you come back and you kill anything you can find.
You have a boyfriend?
Glenn. I don't want that. It's not Christian. Please. Just leave me. Please go.
Okay.
Okay. We'll leave. Just try to take care of yourself for whatever time you have left.
Oh no, don't see the gun!
Gun. So?
Can I borrow it?
What do you mean, borrow?
Give it to me? I can just, you know, end this and then there's no problem.
Whoa.
Please! I don't want to be one of them. They're satanic.
You're gonna be one of them no matter what!
We can't let you do that to yourself.
Then do it for me!
We need to get going.
Give it to me, please!
This is crazy!
Please, step back.
It's just 2 seconds, just one bullet. And I can be with my family, and it'll all be fine.
Miss.
Back up! Please!
Oh, God! Whoa!
Whoa!
Jesus! And you're gonna do it anyway!
Whoa, take it easy. We just want to help.
You can't.
Miss, just relax now. You need to think this through.
Jesus,
we'll
this
find
is deep.
Your doctor. It'll be okay. Let's all just...
No!
God damn it.
Let's get out of here.
Well, there's not much you can do now. And you better get out of here.
Shit!
Here they come! Get in!
Hey, this is Glenn's pizza car!
Everyone alright?
That's
yeah,
sweet.
We had some close calls, but Glenn is fine. And, well, yeah, we're okay.
I've got a few cans of gas for your pickup in the trunk of my car.
Good to hear it.
And things back here?
Quiet. Our friend is still in and out over here. He won't survive any more stress.
The next order of business is getting those pills out of the pharmacy.
Okay. Hopefully that's all. Jesus. Alright, let's just get it done and over with.
How we doing?
Good. Want to go have a look around outside?
Yeah, because I have an axe now.
Let's have a look around.
Okay.
Okay, first we need a distraction. Well, can we just... There you go.
Awesome.
Alright.
Now to distract those things. Carefully.
Think you can do anything with this?
You know what I could do?
What's that?
It's universal. I could program it to work with those TVs across the street. Let's just hope the power is still on.
You can just do that?
That is handy.
I memorized all the codes when I was in AV. Let's try.
Dude, that is handy!
Well fucking done, Doug. All that dork nonsense might save a life.
Say it already hasn't.
Well, that works. Now they just need to be able to hear it.
That got a few of them to take notice.
But not enough.
But not enough.
Well, we gotta take that brick.
Can't reach that brick.
Then open it up! Jesus! How it's done.
Now's the time.
Excuse me. All right, gotta go.
Be careful.
Keep an eye out, will you?
Aw, man, this is gonna be hard. God, you gotta ice your own brother. God damn.
Hey, bud. I don't know what happened to Mom and Dad, but I know if you were there, you would have died for them. So, yeah. I'm gonna assume that's what happened.
Did you find them yet?
Give me a second. I'm sorry, man. I'm sorry I wasn't here. But knowing you were to take care of him through all of it, that helped.
Man, that's deep. You gotta do it, though. That's torture! I mean, I know it's just a zombie, but... Jesus. It's your brother. God. Gotta get the keys.
There we go.
Holy crap!
And now we gotta go. And we just left the gate open. Well, that sucks. You can't lock it up again? Oh, wait, I axed the lock.
Man, that was close.
But we did it. It's all that matters. Got the keys.
Great. God, you're amazing. Let's get in there.
No, now you're all high-spirited. Really? Jesus. Let's go in here and find the pills.
Oh, no.
Oh, shit.
We gotta hurry.
Oh, man. Now we got every zombie after us. That's just what we need, right? Jesus.
Boy. Doc, come on, baby.
time to go.
I'm gonna get the truck pulled up round back!
Do it fast. I gotta get my dad out of here.
I don't plan on dilly-dallying. Honey, take Duck into the office and barricade the living hell out of the door behind me. Glenn, when you hear me honking in the alley, start getting people out of here.
You got it.
Doug, Carly, and Lee, you guys make sure our defenses stay up till then. And Lee, I better take that axe in case I run into any of them on the way to my truck.
Here you go.
Guys, that door's not locked anymore.
Shit! You three, get on it! I'll get back as fast as I can.
Stay away from the windows.
Well, that sucks.
Hey, Lee. If we don't make it through this, you should know that I think you're a great guy.
That's cool!
We will make it through this!
Doug, if we don't make it through this, you should know!
God, just shut up, people!
I should know what?
Huh?
You said I should know...
Shit!
On it.
Are you sure?
Oh, shit!
What? Oh, shit! Okay, then. Clementine, can you look for something to stick in between the handles? Something real strong, okay?
Okay.
Like the cane, maybe?
Clementine, did you find anything?
Nothing! Wait!
The window is screwed!
Go!
I found something!
The cane! Take it!
Get
off! Get off! Oh, come on! I gotta make another dang choice! Man! Carly the Shot or Doug the Techie? You gotta be kidding me. Doug, Carly. Doug, Carly. God damn it. Carly! Because she knows how to shoot him!
No! Get him off of me!
And it's...
Oh my god.
Let's go!
Well, I have the choice.
They...
You gotta move!
Gotta go, Clem.
Covered with this, you son of a bitch!
Hey! No! I just saved your life! Seriously? God! You're an ass!
I'm not letting somebody else get eaten today.
Thank you!
Especially a good friend.
Fucking asshole. God, that sucks, man.
Hey, Glenn.
I think I need to go.
To Atlanta?
Yeah. I got friends there. And I just can't stay here knowing that they could be trapped in that city.
Sounds like nobody knows what's happening there. When we left a few days ago, could have gone either way.
I gotta take my chances.
And
Hey, find your friends, man.
Find your friends. Be safe.
Thanks, Lee. That means a lot. I don't mean to abandon you all, but this seems like an okay setup, and I'm sure things will be back to normal around here in no time.
Let's hope.
You guys be safe.
We'll try.
Bye, Glenn! I know what happens to you in Atlanta. You meet a whole bunch of new friends. Sorry about the background noise. Okay, time to talk to everybody else.
Hey, Kim. Close call back there. Thanks for picking me up.
No problem. We have to take care of each other.
Mm-hmm.
We do.
Earlier, I mentioned you gotta ask yourself what you're gonna do if Clementine's parents don't show.
Yeah, you did.
You think that's gonna happen?
Her parents showing up? No, I don't.
Well, I want you to know that I think you've got it in you. I think you can take care of that little girl just fine.
Thanks, Kitty.
You got it.
All right.
How you doing, Carly?
I'm okay. You know, considering.
I do, yeah.
I can't stop thinking about Doug. We couldn't have saved him, could we?
I don't think so. It happened pretty fast.
I know it's stupid. We just met. And he was such a... It's just that... I think that I liked him.
I'm sorry, Carl.
It's okay. Thanks, though. There's been a lot of death in the past few days. Anyway, I'd rather be alone, I think.
I understand.
Wait, Lee?
What is it?
How did you choose? We both needed you. You picked me.
I was gonna try to help you both.
But you helped me first.
Well, yeah, you're the one with the gun and the shot.
I wish we both could have made it, you know?
Me too, Carmen.
Okay, Doug, you really need to let her go. She's going through a lot.
The Jumatron had this minigun on his shoulder. It's all like pow, pow, pow. I thought Super Dinosaur was toast. But you know what? He wasn't. Oh, and then...
Hey, Duck, you want to cool it for a minute?
Okay, sorry.
I'm sorry, there's not a lot of kids here.
No, it's not that. It's... I got grabbed again.
I was there, though.
I fell, and my walkie-talkie broke. Glenn had the other one.
Aww.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Thanks. I know I need to be tough. I'm just sad. I know it doesn't make any sense, but it's how I used to talk to my mom and dad. And now they're gone. It's gone.
Maybe we can find you another one.
I'll just keep this one, I guess.
Lee, come here for a second.
Let me go deal with this.
Oh, man, Clementine, another thing.
Really? Back to it again, huh?
You like my daughter?
No.
Her dad tried to kill me, so...
Well, he did that because he knows that Lee Everett is a convicted murderer. And so
really?
Anyone else if you go near her.
Really?
You hear me?
You know about me?
I know who you are. And I don't give a shit about what happens to you. But if anything happens to my daughter or that little girl you've got with you, you watch your ass.
Hey, I'm trying to change here.
Hey, Lee, do you have a second?
God, what's up with everyone wanting me? I just want this freaking video over with.
My dad would be dead if it weren't for you.
Yeah, well, he tried to kill me.
Dead because of me.
You can't be like that. You're only one man.
I don't know.
We're lucky to have you.
Uh, I hope that's the sound of us winning this thing.
Me too.
This motor end's pretty damn defendable. We block off the entrances with some cars, keep someone on watch. We could stay here until the military rolls through.
I actually agree with that plan.
Me too. We got beds, we got water, and most importantly, we got light. There are worse places to call home.
Yeah, you're right. You know, guys, I think it's going to be okay.
Yeah, for now. Lights out. Okay, I'm gonna wrap this video here. Hope you guys like it. Oh, right, next time on The Walking Dead. I forgot they do that, like, you know, stuff.
I thought we'd be fine if we survived the walkers. Never expected they'd starve us out.
I want you to have this, okay? In case you or Clementine starts feeling weak.
You don't owe me anything, Carly. How you doing, Clementine?
I'm really hungry, Lee.
We gotta get food, Lee. Soon.
Howdy. I'm Andrew St. John. We're from the St. John Dairy.
It's beautiful.
I never did thank you for saving Duck from the walkers back at Herschel's farm.
Something's coming, Lee. There's gonna be a war.
The walkers don't worry me as much as the bandits.
No more, please! No more, please! Please, please!
Okay, well, okay, that was a preview for the next episode, so, like I tried to say before, I'm gonna leave this video off here. Lie to Herschel, you were honest, save Duck. Defended Kenny, gave Irene the gun. I chose Carly. About half. Okay. Like I said, I'm gonna leave it off here. Thanks for watching, guys. Hit that like button, hit that subscribe, and Triple-Dunc!